Welcome back to YouTube live classes. So let us continue with the next topic of the chapter 5, complex numbers and quadratic equations. So the next topic is the modulus and conjugate of a complex number. So complex number will be given and we will have to find its modulus and the conjugate. So let's take up the complex number as z equal to a plus ib. I'll be taking the complex number as let z, which is equals to a plus ib. So this is a complex number. Let z equal to a plus ib be a complex number, then the modulus of this complex number is denoted by mod z. Then the modulus, then the modulus of z is denoted by, the modulus of z is denoted by mod z, is two vertical bars and z, so mod z. So now, and is defined to be, and is defined as, and is defined as mod z, which is equals to square root of a square plus b square. So this is how we take the modulus of the complex number. So here square root of the real part square, what is a square? It is square of the real part plus square of the imaginary part. A plus ib is a complex number. Here a is the real part and b is the imaginary part. If we take square root of a square plus b square, that will be the modulus of the complex number. I will give an example for this. Let us give an example for this. Example, I'll take z, which is equals to 2 plus 3i or i3. So now find the modulus of this particular complex number. So mod z which is equals to square root of a square. What is a here? A is 2. So we get 2 square plus 3 square. 2 square plus 3 square. So mod z, which is equals to square root of 2 square, it will be 4, plus 3 square, it will be 9. So 4 plus 9, it will be square root of 13. So this is the modulus of the given complex number. So z equal to 2 plus 3i is a complex number whose modulus is mod z equal to square root of 13. This is how you need to find the modulus. So usually this question will be given for 1 mark. Then next we will have to go for, the conjugate of a complex number. Well, so here we consider z equal to a plus ib as a complex number. Z equal to a plus ib is a complex number. Then whose conjugate is given by z bar? Whose conjugate is denoted by z bar, that is z bar, which is equals to a minus I b. Z bar, which is equals to a minus ib. So this is the conjugate of the given complex number. So here what we have done, so a we have written it as it is, the real part is written as it is. The only thing that has been changed is the sign of the imaginary part. If it is plus here, we will have to write minus. In case if it is minus here, we will have to write plus. So this is the conjugate of the given complex number. Again, this, you know, it is, concept is going to be very important for 1 mark. Usually they'll give one complex number, find its conjugate. Let us take an example. So for this I'll give two examples. Example one, so let z, which is equals to minus 3 plus 2i, minus 3 plus 2i is a complex number. So let us find the conjugate of this particular complex number. Now find its conjugate, then. So here z bar which is equals to, what did I tell you? We have to write the real part as it is. Then change the sign of the imaginary part. Here the sign of imaginary part, it is plus. Now we will have to change it to minus. Minus 2i. So this is the answer for the example 1. I'll go for example 2 now. Example 2, z which is equals to minus 3i plus 2. So now we have to find the conjugate of this particular complex number. What is the complex number here? Z equal to minus 3i plus 2. So z bar, that means it is the conjugate of the given complex number, z bar, which is equals to. So what was the rule? The rule is we have to change only the sign of the imaginary part and write the sign of the real part as it is. So here minus 3i, so 3i is the imaginary part, so we have to change its sign, so it becomes plus 3i. Then write the real part as it is. Don't change the sign of the real part now. The rule says we have to write the real part as it is. That is, I'll be writing plus 2 as it is. So this is the, you know, conjugate of the given complex number. So this is regarding the modulus and conjugate of the complex number. And then we'll go for the important properties. Well, next, we are going to list out some of the important properties of conjugate of a complex number and modulus of a complex number. So in that, the first one, Roman number one, it is mod z1 z2, this is equals to. So what does this indicates now? Z1 z2 is a product of two complex numbers. You are taking, you know, modulus of that product. Z1 z2 is a product of two complex numbers. So if we take modulus of this one, we get mod z1 z2. So mod z1 z2 can be written as mod z1 into mod z2. So this is the property 1. Then let us go for the property 2, Roman number 2. So here mod z1 by z2 can be written as mod z2 divided by mod z2, provided mod z2 should not be equal to 0. This denominator should not be equal to 0. So these two are the properties regarding the modulus of a complex number. Then next I'll be listing out the properties regarding the conjugate of a complex number. Then the next property, Roman number 3, it is, so here z1 z2 is a product of two complex numbers. If you take the conjugate of that product, it becomes, so this can be written as z1 bar into z2 bar. Then the next one, Roman number 4, z1 plus or minus z2 the whole bar can be written as z1 bar plus or minus z2 bar. Then write the last property now, z1 by z2 the whole bar, z1 by z2 the whole bar, this is equals to z1 bar divided by z2 bar, provided z2 should not be equal to 0, provided z2 should not be equal to 0. So these are the important properties regarding the modulus and conjugate of a complex number, and then I'll move on to the next concept. Well, the next example problem, it is example 5. Find the multiplicative inverse of 2 minus 3i. So here the given complex number is 2 minus 3i. We have to find its multiplicative inverse. So in the multiplication of two complex numbers, we have discussed an important property, that is existence of multiplicative inverse and existence of multiplicative identity. So briefly I will be covering them. So this is 2 minus 3i. So if z is a complex number, what number must be multiplied to this complex number so that we get the answer as z? That means for this, if you multiply by 1, you get the same complex number. So see here, I am multiplying by 1 to the given complex number to get the original complex number. So here 1 is going to be the multiplicative identity. So this is the existence of multiplicative identity. Here 1 is the multiplicative identity. Then now what number must be multiplied to z so that we get the answer as 1? That means we will have to multiply by 1 by z. So here z and z get cancelled, so we get the answer as 1. So here 1 by z is the multiplicative inverse. The existence of multiplicative inverse means 1 by z is the multiplicative inverse. 1 by z, here the power will be 1. Now take this z to the power 1 to the numerator, it becomes z to the power minus 1. So overall here multiplicative inverse indicates z inverse. So we should, you know, call this as z inverse or 1 by z. So that's what we have to find here. So let us go ahead the finding 1 by z or z inverse. Well, I'll take this as the complex number z. Z which is equals to 2 minus 3i. So this is the given complex number. Now we will have to find 1 by z or z inverse. So here z inverse, this is equals to 1 by z. Z inverse equal to 1 by z. Then z inverse which is equals to 1 divided by what is z? It is 2 minus 3i. 2 minus 3i. Now in the next step we will have to go for rationalization, multiply and divide by the opposite sign of the denominator. So let us do that now. So now z, 2 minus 3i, then z inverse which is equals to 1 divided by 2 minus 3i. Now multiply and divide by 2 plus 3i. 2 plus 3i, and here also 2 plus 3i. Then, so now z inverse which is equals to 1 into 2 plus 3i, it will be 2 plus 3i. 2 plus 3i, then divided by, these two are in the form of a minus b, a minus b into a plus b. A minus b into a plus b can be written as a square minus b square. So z inverse which is equals to now rewrite the denominator. Now 1 into 2 plus 3i, it is 2 plus 3i. A minus b into a plus b can be written as a square, that is 2 square, minus b square, that is 3i the whole square. So now z inverse which is equals to 2 plus 3i divided by 2 square, it will be 4, then minus 3, this square applies to 3 as well as, you know, I. So we get 3 square, that is 9, into I square, into I square. So now here z inverse which is equals to 2 plus 3i 2 plus 3i divided by 4, I'll be writing it as it is. Then what is the value of I square? I square value, it is minus 1. Minus into minus, it will be plus. You get plus 9. Plus 9. Z inverse, which is equals to, so 2 plus 3i divided by 13. Then now split this into two terms. Z inverse, which is equals to 2 by 13 plus 3 by 13 into I, I'll be writing it as it is. 2 by 13. I'm splitting the numerator into two terms. So 2 by 13 plus 3 by 13 into I. So this is going to be the multiplicative inverse of the given complex number. Usually, no such problems will be given for 2 marks. So I hope you have got the multiplicative inverse concept. Then I'll move on to the next one. Well, the next example problem, it is example 6. Express the following in the form of a plus ib. The Roman number 1, it is 5 plus root 2 I divided by 1 minus root 2 I. So I'll take this as Z. So let us express this complex number in the form of a plus ib. Take this as Z now. Z, which is equals to 5 plus square root of 2 into I divided by 1 minus square root of 2 then I. Now I'll go for the rationalization. Multiply and divide by the opposite sign of the denominator. So what I'll do is 1 plus root 2 I, 1 plus root 2 I divided by 1 plus root 2 I. Then Z, which is equals to, multiply the numerators now. 5 into 1, it will be 5. Then 5 into root 2 plus 5 into root 2 I, then plus root 2 I into 1, it is root 2 I. Then now multiply these two terms. So root 2 into root 2, it will be 2 plus 2. Then I into I, root 2 into root 2, it will be root 4. What is root 4? It is 2. That's what I've written. Root 2 into root 2, it is 2. I into I, it will be I square. It will be I square whole divided by. Now these two are in the form of a minus b into a plus b. Can be written as a square minus b square. So we get 1 square minus root 2 I the whole square. Simplify this further now. Well, Z, which is equals to, so 5, I'll be writing it as it is. Then 5 times root 2 I plus root 2 I. So add these two, we get 6 times root 2 I. So plus 6 times square root of 2 into I. Then here the value of I square, it will be minus 1. So overall we get minus 2 divided by 1 square, it will be 1. Then this square applies to first term as well as to the second term. Then so here square and root get cancels, we get 2. So we get 2. Then I square value, it is minus 1. I'll be writing minus 1 here. Then Z, which is equals to 5 minus 2, it is 3 plus 3 plus 6 times root 2 I divided by minus into minus, it is plus 1 plus 2, it will be 3. 1 plus 2, it will be 3. In the next step, we take 3 common in the numerator. Z, which is equals to, I'll be taking 3 common, we get 1 plus 2 root 2 I divided by 3. So these two get cancels now. So what is the answer? It is 1 plus 2 times root 2 I. This is the required answer. So then we'll move on to the next example problem. So this is how we need to solve. Example 6 was, express the following in the form a plus ib. Then this is the solution. Well, then I'll go for the next one. Well, the next, you know, example, it is I to the power minus 35. We have to express this in the form of a plus ib. So let us take this as z. Z which is equals to I raised to minus 35. So z which is equals to, take this to the denominator, it becomes 1 divided by I raised to plus 35. 1 divided by I raised to plus 35. Now what I'll do is, in the next step, I'll multiply and divide by I. Z which is equals to 1 by I to the power 35 into I divided by I. So here there will be power 1. A raised to m into a raised to n will be a raised to m plus n. That means these two powers will be added up now. So what do we get? Z which is equals to 1 into I, it is I, divided by, we get I raised to 36. So in the previous class, I had given one property. So I raised to 4k, is always 1, where k is any integer. So now if we take k as 9, 4 into 9 we get 36, I to the power 36, it is 1. So that's what we have now. So in the next step, z which is equals to I divided by 1. So whenever you get I to the power number which is multiple of 4, then that value will always be 1. So that is why I have replaced I raised to 36 by 1. What is I by 1? It is I. So z which is equals to, you know, here I'll write I. So now write this I in the form of a plus ib. Don't get confused. So I'll write I here. Now we will have to write this in the form of a plus ib. Here we have only the imaginary part. Real part is missing here. So the real part is missing means we will have to write 0. So 0 plus I. This is there in the form of a plus ib. B value, it is 1 here. So this is the, you know, solution for the Roman number 2. This is how you need to solve. Well, so then we'll move on to the next one. Well, with this we have completed the introduction part of exercise 5.1. Now let us get into the exercise 5.1. The main question is, express the following functions in the a plus ib form from problem number 1 to problem number 10. From question number 1 to question number 10, we have to express them in the form of a plus ib. So let us solve this. I'll take this as z which is equals to, so now 5i, the given complex number is 5i into minus 3 by 5 I, minus 3 by 5i. So z which is equals to, I'll multiply the numbers now, 5 into minus 3 by 5. So you get minus 5 into 3 by 5. Then I into I, it will be I square. We get I square. So here 5 and 5 get cancels. Z which is equals to, what do we have? Minus 3. I square, it will be minus 1. So now z which is equals to minus 3 into minus 1, it will be plus 3. So but we have to express this in the form of a plus ib. Here we have only the real part, imaginary part is missing. So we have to write 0 I. So z which is equals to 3 plus I into 0. 0 into I, it will be 0. So overall we get 3 plus 0, that is 3. So now we have expressed this 3 in the form of a plus ib. This is the answer for the question number 1. So this is how you need to solve. So this is the solution for the question number 1. Then I'll go for the question number 2. Well, the question number 2, it is I to the power 9 plus I to the power 19. We have to express this in the form of a plus ib. Let us go ahead with the solution. I'll take this as z. This is equals to I raised to 9 plus I raised to 19. I raised to 9 plus I raised to 19. So now Z, which is equals to, I'll be writing this as I to the power 8 into I to the power 1. I raised to 8 into I raised to 1 plus, here I'll be writing this as I to the power 16 into I to the power 3. I raised to 16 into I raised to 3. So see here, A raised to M into A raised to N. That means powers will be added up. 8 plus 1, it will be 9. 16 plus 3, it will be 19. So now, Z which is equals to I to the power 8 value, it will be 1. Because 8 is a multiple of 4, whereas 16 is a multiple of 4. Or else these two can be written as I square whole raised to 4. I square whole raised to 4. Or in other way, you can write as I raised to 4 the whole square into I plus, this can be written as I to the power 4 whole to the power 4 into I cube. So now Z which is equals to I raised to 4, it is 1. 1 square, it will be 1. 1 into I. So overall we get 1 into I plus I raised to 4, it is again 1. 1 to the power 4, it is 1. 1 into I cube. I cube value, it will be minus I. I cube can be written as I square into I. What is the value of I square? This we have already discussed. I square value, it is minus 1. Minus 1 into I, it will be minus I. So I will be replacing I cube by minus I. So it can be replaced by minus I. Z which is equals to 1 into I, it is I. So here it is minus I. So plus I minus I get cancels. We get 0 as the answer. Z which is equals to 0. Now we will have to express this in the form of A plus IB. So it can be written as Z which is equals to 0 plus I into 0. So this is there in the A plus IB form. So this is how you need to solve the question number 2. This is how you need to solve the question number 2. Then I'll go for the question number 3. Sorry. Where is that question? Well, the question number 3, it is I to the power minus 39. Question number 3, it is I raised to minus 39. So now we will have to express this in the form of A plus IB. So I'll be taking this as I. I'll be taking this as Z, not I, sorry. I to the power minus 39. So Z which is equals to, now take this to the denominator, it becomes 1 divided by I raised to plus 39. 1 divided by I raised to plus 39. Now in the next step, what I'll do is I'll be multiplying and dividing by I. So Z which is equals to 1 divided by I raised to 39. Now multiply and divide by I. So here in the denominator we get I raised to 39 into I raised to 1, that is going to be I raised to 40, that value will be 1. So for that reason I am multiplying and dividing by I here. So then let us go ahead. Z which is equals to 1 into I, it is I, divided by I raised to 39 into I raised to 1, it will be I raised to 40. What is the value of I raised to 40? It will be 1. So Z which is equals to I divided by 1, because I raised to the number which is multiple of 4, it is 1. So now overall we get Z which is equals to I by 1, that is I. Now express this in the form of A plus IB. Z which is equals to 0 plus I into 1. 0 plus I into 1. So this is there in the A plus IB form.
So this is all about the question number 3. Then I'll be going for the question number 4. Well, let us solve the question number 4. Let us take this as z, which is equals to 3 into the bracket 7 plus I into 7, then plus I 7 plus I into 7. 7 plus I into 7. So now here multiply 3 with these two terms and then I with these two terms. So let us do that now. Z which is equals to 3 into 7 it is 21 plus 3 into I 7. 3 into I 7 it will be 21i. 21i plus I into 7 it will be 7i plus 7i, then plus I into I 7 will be 7i square. 7i square. Then simplify this further now. 21 I will be rating it as it is, plus 21i plus 7i will be 28i. 28i. Then here I square value it will be minus 1. Minus 1 into 7. It will be minus 7. So we get minus 7. In the next step, z which is equals to 21 minus 7, it will be 14 plus 28i plus 28i. This is there in the form of a plus bi or a plus ib. So this is all about the question number 4. Then I'll be moving on to question number 5. Let us solve the question number 5. Well, so let us take this as z which is equals to 1 minus I, then minus 1 plus I 6, minus 1 plus I 6. So z which is equals to 1 minus I, multiply minus with these two terms, minus into minus it will be plus 1, minus into plus it is minus I 6. Then z which is equals to, so here 1 plus 1 it will be 2, then minus I minus I 6 it will be minus 7i. So we get minus 7i, or this can also be written as z which is equals to 2 plus I into minus 7. This is there in the form of a plus IB. So this is all about the question number 5. So note down all these things. Then in tomorrow's class, I'll be continuing with the question number 6. Thank you all.